Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to show you how I use a online application on my Chromebook to edit a lot of the photos that you see that I use in my videos. And of course the program that I use is called LunaPic. Now, LunaPic is a great program. You don't have to download anything onto your machine, which is kind of nice. I'll show you how to capture or to grab the images that are created, so you don't have to download them using their app or anything like that. You can actually, there's other ways to do that. And I'll show you some of the features too. So let's show you how. So here we are at lunapic.com. Now to find it, simply open up your browser. You can do this on a Windows or on a Macintosh, even on a Chromebook, and browse to lunapic.com. Once you've done that, this page will open up as you see here. First thing that we want to do is we want to click on upload, which is that very first key there. And we now click on choose file. And I'm going to choose this photo of a river that's not too far from my house. There we are. And it will load as you see here. Now we can do such things as crop, scale, rotate, even make things transparent. We can add separate photos on top of each other, make one slightly transparent and the other one is at full strength there. So there's many things you can do with just the words that you see here, but you also have tools such as a cropping tool. Cropping is, if I was to click on the cropping tool, you can actually go in and say, well, I just want this area of the image, and then I can click on crop. Now I'm only looking at that portion of the image. So I've cropped out part of the image there. And there's other things. You can add text. You can actually cut out certain things in the photo. That would be used if you were using two images and combining the two images. So really, LunaPic can do so many different things here. There's a drawing tool, zooming in. You can rotate the image. You can add a gradient of color. You also have the paint bucket tool that fills an area of the image based on the color similarity. Click anywhere on the image and the paint bucket will fill that area around the pixel with a new color. The eyedropper will pick a color, so if you want to replace the sky with, make it green or something, you can do weird things like that. So there's many, many tools here that you can see and you can all use. What I'm going to be focusing on is actually going up here to the art, and we can do many different things with the image, really make it artistic. One of the things that we could do, let me go first to effects, tilt shift. So I'm going to click on tilt shift. It will process the image, and there we go. Now look at that. It took my image or the photo of the river and it made it into this, what's called tilt shift, and that makes it look miniaturized. So I did that with a number of my images already to test it out, and it's beautiful. Now let's say that you wanted this image. All you have to do is right click the image and then say save image as. That's one way to save it. You could actually use their tools to download the image and all that, but I'm not going to be doing that. So right now I'm just going to be showing you, if you right click the image and then click on save image as, then you can save it onto your hard drive and then use it in your other work. Now I'm going to click on undo this effect because I want to show you other wonderful effects that can be done here. And now I'm going to go into art and I'm going to click on famous artworks. And the very first one I'm going to show you is just called Fairy. So I'm going to click on Fairy. It'll process the image and voila, you now have this really nice large image here. And it looks just like a painting. I mean, that's beautiful. That is just one out of many different effects that it does. Let's click on undo this effect. And I'm gonna go back to famous artworks. And as you can see, there's many different ones here. So the list goes on. You can even use your own style. So let's say that you have a painting or you have another artwork that you've already created. You can actually click on use your own style, upload that one, and then use the colors and the effects on that image on one of your separate images, which is absolutely amazing. All I'm going to do is click on sketch number 4. And now it's going to change my river scene into a sketch. So there it is as a sketch. And notice I have keep your colors. I'm going to click that off. And it's going to reprocess it. And now it looks like a sketch. Pretty nice, huh? I'm going to click on undo effect. And let's try something else out. If I was to go down to, red blush. That is absolutely stunning. That's just a beautiful picture there with just one filter being used. Now you can actually combine filters. So I'm going to undo this effect here. And undo is I'm going to go into effects, go down to, as you can see, there's many filters, borders, there's draw tools, adjusting tools. I can edit. I can have multiple layers just like I would if I was using Photoshop. Look at all these files. I can do anything with the file. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to effects and go down to tilt shift. So I'm going to apply the tilt shift filter. So I have it that way. And then I'm going to go to famous artworks. I'm going to go down to fairy. Let it process those two. And now it's processed those two images and that's the result. So you can combine multiple effects as you see here. You can actually have animation as well. Now animation is good when you have multiple images, so you can actually upload multiple images. So if I was going to transitions, and then right here where it says choose file, I could choose multiple files and have different transitions going on and actually make kind of like a gift animation, which is pretty amazing. So I'm going to click on zoom animation. And there you can see it zooming in on one of the trees, which is kind of nice. All right, well let's go ahead and again, if you wanted to save this, you simply right click on the image and then click on save image as, and then you can choose the file name and the folder that you want to save it as. Right now I'm going to click on upload and I'm going to click on choose file. I'm going to choose another file to upload. This time I'm going to choose a family picture. So this is my family. So there we are. And let's see what the effects are when I use famous artworks. And we could choose any of these. So let's choose, again, let's choose sketch number 4. So there we are. That is a nice sketch. And I can scroll down. And what I'm going to do is if I click on use your or keep your colors, it'll process again and then redraw it using my colors. Another beautiful picture that you can use on one of your projects, and you want to share it on Facebook or something. Again, if I really like that image, I would right click it and then click on save image as. And we'll click on undo this effect. And then I'm going to go to art and let's go down to fairy and see what happens when it redraws us using that effect. And as you can see, that is a beautiful image there. That's nice. I can just do this all day. In fact, I actually do spend a lot of time on this application at this website, working with so many different of my images, and yeah, I use them in my videos. So hopefully you found this video rather helpful. There are many more features than what I've shown here in LunaPic. One of the questions that usually people ask is, well, how safe is LunaPic? Well, it's not number one. It's not rated number one as far as being, you know, for your privacy and all that, but it's still very good. If you do notice, I'm not downloading the application to my Chromebook or to my Windows machine. I'm simply using the online app. I'm uploading my photos, and I wouldn't recommend that you upload, you know, private photos, if you know what I mean. Just simply use your regular photos, something that you'd want to share or that you'd be sharing anyway on Facebook. And like I said, there are many, many more things you can actually do with your images with LunaPic. So hopefully you found this video helpful. Please give it a thumbs up if you haven't done so. Please subscribe to my channel and share the video as well. This is my only income currently, so when you click on thumbs up and you comment down below, share the video, that really helps with the income. Thank you very much. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave you with more examples of what LunaPic can actually do. And so thank you again, and bye-bye.